Hey, what's up? Adam Lobo here from Adam Lobo TV. Yes, do you like my new setup? Because I'm not in the studio, but all the way in Apple Park in Cupertino for WWDC 2023, as I mentioned in my previous video. Now, there are too many goodies to talk about, so strap up and let's go. Now, Apple surprisingly went hard on hardware, this time around with three new Macs. So let's talk about the new 15-inch MacBook Air first. Now, the brand new 11.5mm thin MacBook Air will be fanless, weighs just under 1.51 kgs, and features a 15.3-inch liquid retina display. Now, powering this device is the M2 chip, which supports up to 24GB of unified memory and 2TB of storage. Then other notable specs will be the 1080p webcam, 6 speakers, MagSafe charging, 2 Thunderbolt ports, and a 3.5mm headphones jack. Now, it has a claimed 18 hours of battery life, and it starts at a price of 5,729 ringgit for the education and 6,199 ringgit for the official retail price, and it'll come in 4 colors. Then, a new Mac Studio will also be coming soon with a brand new M2 Ultra chip. Now, like the M1 Ultra, it is basically a combination of two M2 Macs chip together, where it features a 24 CPU cores, 32 neural engine cores, and up to 72 CPU cores. Then the unified memory RAM can be configured to a mind-boggling 192GB. Now, to give some perspective on the performance, it can run at 22 streams of 8K video all at once. And those are some hardcore numbers over there. What's the price? It starts from 9,499 ringgit and 8,549 ringgit for education. Then as for the final Mac, we are finally getting an update on the Mac Pro. That is powered by Apple's M2 Ultra chip. It has the same tower design with an updated internal design with 6 open PCIe Gen 4 slots, 4 expansion and 8 Thunderbolt ports built in. And it starts at just 32,999 ringgit and 32,669 ringgit for education. Now, as you may or may not know, that Apple has also released one hardware, but don't worry, I'll talk about that later. Now, if you guys are enjoying this video so far, especially this kind of content after the event, do give this video a nice big thumbs up, and of course a subscription would be lovely too. And if you guys want to see a written version of this, I will link to our website at www.adamlobo.tv down below, and also our community Discord channel for us to chat further over there. So let's move along. Now, as for software, there are major updates that is coming to iOS 17, and this could be broken down to basically being very customized, very simple, and also very convenient. Now, first, the phone app will have contact posters where you can customize how you're portrayed to the other person when making a call. Then you can share your contact, similar like how you would do on an AirDrop, but this is called Name Drop, where it will also work from iPhone to an Apple Watch. Then there's live voicemail, where there'll be a live text displayed on the phone screen as the person leaves a voicemail, so you can read and actually pick up the call mid-through. Then on FaceTime, you can also leave a video voicemail if a person doesn't pick up your call at that moment in time. Then Messages gets a huge update with improved search, catch up with long conversations easier with an arrow up button which takes you to the first message that you haven't seen, swipe to reply, and automatic message transcription to know what people are saying in an audio message without actually listening to it, and inline location to give you a live location. Then there's also a check-in feature where you can let a loved one know if you reach home safely automatically or if you're delayed, and if there's no response from you, the app will let your loved one know your last location along with the route that you took. Now, this is quite a super useful and a safety feature, which I think is great that it is coming on iOS 17. Then on the keyboard side, autocorrect has been much improved with a new transformer language model, where it's not only more accurate but also customized to your style of writing. Then dictation has also been improved along with predictions on what you want to type next appearing inline as you type. Then the journaling app is now official as predicted, where it suggests and inspires you what to write from the photos, your music, recent connections among other things. You can bookmark entries that are important to you, and you can even schedule reminders to write something. Now don't worry, because everything is kept in the device, and you also have the ability to lock your app. So don't worry about how your mom, your uncle, your auntie, or your brother or sister is going to be taking your phone and look into your journaling app. Then is one of my major favorites, which is this standby feature, where if you set your iPhone horizontally while charging, it can host useful information like the time, calendar and widgets. You can even see food delivery status, have HomeKit smartphone controls, or even turn your phone into a digital photo album. Then Siri is always on standby for iOS 17, so you don't have to say hey before Siri to activate it. Then there are other smaller updates, including offline maps and your photo gallery being able to recognize your pets. Now, iPad OS 17 had smaller highlights, such as having the ability to customize your lock screen and add widgets to the side and live activities, such as keeping multiple running timers at the same time. And the health app is finally available for iPad. And as for a person like me who always uses an iPad when I'm on a treadmill, this would be very beneficial for me and probably for you as well. Then there's also a comprehensive PDF feature where you can now take pictures of documents and have them to auto-fill information, which saves a lot of time. And you can even add multiple PDFs into your notes and live collaborate with another iPad. So the new Mac OS is called Sonoma. Now, never in a million years that I would predict that, so that was kind of cool. So, here's new. There are brand new screensavers and widgets that can be dragged to anywhere on your desktop screen for easy viewing. And what's cool is that it will automatically fade away when you open a new app, which definitely looks cool. You can even use your iPhone apps on your Mac without natively being installed in your Mac, which was really great to know. Now, a big shocker is the appearance from Hideo Kojima with its announcement of a director's cut of Death Stranding that will be coming to Mac soon. Now, here's where it really shows that Apple is taking gaming very seriously on the Mac, and there's also a brand new game mode that will prioritize your computer's resources to gaming when it's activated. Then there's a new overlay for video conferences where you can present yourself as a small bubble or a big person with a presentation sandwiched between you and your background to give you that sort of a professional look when presenting. There's also a set of new video reactions that could be used to spice things up during online meetings as well. Then there's also other smaller audio updates with the new adaptive audio mode where the AirPods Pro now merges transparency and active noise cancellation to give the best of both worlds that will automatically lower or increase each depending on your surroundings. Then AirPlay will also be available in selected hotels where you just need to scan a QR code and stream your content on the hotel's TV without using a HDMI cable from your Mac to the TV, which I usually tend to do. Then there's also a new SharePlay system in CarPlay where you can join your playlist in the car to add your favorite songs in the car with this new SharePlay system. Then tvOS is getting a new redesigned interface, and you can use the iPhone to locate your missing Apple remote, select memories from your iPhone to be used as a TV screensaver, and FaceTime for Apple TV, where you can just connect your iPhone or iPad and use the camera and display it on the Apple TV. Now, a surprising chunk of the presentation for software updates actually came in the form of watchOS 10. Now, first, there's a new user interface with a digital crown being able to use to show smart stacks of apps that uses machine learning on which apps to show up first. Then there's also a new corner icons for more functionality for apps. A new cycling workout app is now included, which uses machine learning to estimate your maximum capability on a bike. Then hiking has a major update too, where it shows the last place that you are at the telco reception, where you can send SOS messages on any carrier. Then there's two new apps that has been added to the mindfulness app, which is to better gauge your mental health state, and a vision health to help you mitigate future eye problems by telling you to stay further away from the screen if you get very close to your devices. Okay, now for the biggest reveal that we, and I'm sure you, have been waiting for, the Apple Vision Pro headset. Now, this is a really beautiful piece of technology. It is so beautiful that it's so hard to put words to it, but you know what? I'll try my best. So the Vision Pro is an augmented reality headset that Apple envisions to take the VR and AR experience to a whole new other level. Now imagine that you can take your computer screen and just paste it in front of you in every corner of your eyes, and you can apply to everything that you see into the real world. Now the physical product itself is quite unique, as there's an OLED screen in front that is able to display your eyes to let people see whether or not you're busy on the headset, or able to see you in real time with this new feature called EyeSight. Then it's using the Vision OS software, where if you open the apps, it will float in front of you. And you can turn the digital crown on the headset, where you can increase or lower the boundaries between real life and the digital experience. Now, what's even cooler is that you don't even need controllers to control what you see, because the Vision Pro will track your eyes and see what exactly that you want to select. And you can even use finger gestures to activate what you want to do. And you can even use voice control too. Then watching movies goes to a whole new level. You can even have a cinema-like experience by expanding the movie as wide as you want to have a more immersive experience. Then Apple is also working directly with Disney, and Disney Plus will be available on the device from the get-go. Now you can even create a 3D spatial video using the device. Now imagine capturing a live moment in 3D and being able to play it back in 3D as you were there at the right moment in time again. Then as for security, there's a new iris scanning feature called Optic ID that automatically scans your eyes to unlock the Vision Pro. So with this kind of technology, Apple needs not one but two chipsets One is the M2 chipset and a new R1 chipset, which is specifically made for this VR headset. Now, as for battery life, you get about 2 hours per charge, but you can keep it plugged in to get an all-day use. Then the headset itself is modular to give you the best fit it possibly can. And they're also working with Zeiss to give you an additional prescription lenses if you need so to get the best experience without glasses on. Now, as for the price, it comes with a very cool $3,499 USD. Now, it's definitely far from affordable for the average Joe, but considering the hardware cost itself, that is very much expected. And since Apple has over 5,000 patents in this product, I really do understand where they're coming from with this kind of price factor. So yes, guys, that was definitely a lot to take in, quite overwhelming, in fact. So with this, do let me know your thoughts and which one of these announcements that you like the most in the comment section below.